So we said that there will be two forces F restoring, where F restoring is directly proportional to y, and F damping, which is directly proportional to velocity. This is an important point to note that damping force is directly proportional to what? Velocity, or you can say dy by dt. So our F net becomes what? It will be F restoring plus of F damping, because restoring force is due to what? Its spring, and damping is due to what? The air resistance being provided by the external factors. So F net becomes Fr plus Fd. So put the values, you know that it is minus k times y. So removing the proportionality constant or sign, you got R dy by dt. Now this R is called as damping constant. Damping constant. Why it is opposing force? Because it's a resistive force only. So it's a negative sign. Is that clear to you? So you have to remember that damping is directly proportional to velocity. So you write it F net as Fr plus F times d. So F net becomes what? Minus k minus r dy by dt. So this F net becomes plus r dy by dt plus k times y is equals to 0. Now due to Newton's laws of motion, can I write F net as mass into acceleration, and acceleration as d2y by dt square? See, we will be studying force vibrations also. Everything is same. If you get to know that what to write in F net, you will be able to set up the differential equation very easy. See, in mass spring system, we have written F net is only have F restoring. Whereas in damping, we have seen F net has F restoring as well as F damping. Whereas when we study force vibration, we will see F restoring, F damping and F external. So set up the differential equation will be easy for you if you get the concept for this. Is that clear? The concept is same for all the stuff. In LC and LCR circuit will be most easy, because again and again you will be doing the same thing. Is that clear to you? So you get that M of d2y by dt square plus R of dy by dt plus k times y is equals to 0. Now divided by m, you got as d2y by dt square r by m dy by dt plus k times m dy equals to 0. Now we name k by m as omega square. So we will name this omega square. And now we will name r by m as 2b. So the equation becomes d2y by dt square plus 2 times b dy by dt plus omega square y is equals to 0. This is called as differential equation of damping oscillation. Damping oscillation, where this b is known as damping coefficient. B is known as damping coefficient. So you can write here as that 2b is equals to r by m and omega square is equals to k by m is our substitution. Remember the fact that r is damping constant and b is damping coefficient. Many of the times I found that many of you will get confused with B and R. So please get the data clearly, whether it says damping constant or a damping coefficient. Okay, it's a common observation we found. Then we have to solve this differential equation. For solving this differential equation, what we have to do is, we have to take the help of Max. And we take the help, like the differential equation was d2y by dt square plus 2 times b dy by dt plus omega square y equals to 0. Now we take the help of max, and max says the solution is a e power alpha t. See, according to math, this is a partial differential equation, okay? It is, the solution will be the form of a e power alpha t. Means we have to get the values of alpha. Now how we are getting, how we physicians are getting this value alpha, that is a very tricky way. So we got y, now we will find dy by dt. Then we will find d2y by dt square, and then we will put back this equation here. That is, you got y. So now we will find dy by dt, can anyone? A alpha e alpha t. So can anyone tell d2y by dt square is what? A alpha square e alpha times t. Put this equation here. A alpha square e alpha times t plus 2 times b. A alpha e alpha t plus omega square a e alpha t. What I have did nothing but I have put all the values which we have taken from max to in this equation. Now anything you can take common, yeah. A e power alpha t. So when you take this common, what is that? Alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square equals to 0. Now when you see this kind of situation, you have to say that either this has to be 0 or this has to be 0. Means out of two possibilities, one has to 0, which will give the solution. Now if I talk about a e alpha t has to be 0, if I say a e alpha t is 0, then what will happen? Now everything, now a e alpha t is common to everyone, means it will give zero solution every time. It will give zero solution in spite of alpha. You put any alpha, if a e alpha t is zero, it will give zero. That is, you says in mathematics it's a non-trivial solution. Are you getting that? So when we say this is zero, it gives non-trivial solution, means every time it will give 0 0 0 only, okay? Whereas, so this case is being rejected. By V says either this to 0 or this be 0. When I talk about this solution, this can't be 0. Because if it is 0, it always gives 0 solution. Whereas if this will become 0, it will satisfy the equation. Therefore, this is rejected, this is accepted, because this is what? A quadratic equation. Only for two values, this will give us 0 solution. So alpha square plus 2b times alpha plus omega square is 0. It's a quadratic equation. For quadratic equation, if you know, the solution is minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So you put this equation, I know that plus minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So in spite of b, it will be 2b. In spite of 4b square, it will be this, and 4 omega square upon 2, it will be this. Now taking 2 common, 2 will cancel out. So you get it as alpha as minus b plus minus root over b square minus omega square. Now general solution was this. So we have to, now we have got 2 values of alpha. So how to depict 2 values of alpha as? While the general solution is, so I take new constant c e minus b plus or root b square minus omega square times t. That is e alpha t plus d, any constant d, minus b minus of b square minus omega square. So it is written as a e alpha t only, but we have two alphas, that why I have bifurcated c and d. So this is the general solution we come across. Now this is the general solution we come across. Now we have to study the cases, okay? So the cases will depend on what factor. See, only this factor is very contradictory, because if root becomes a positive or greater than 0, then we says what? It has a real solution with distinct values. If it is 0, we says equal values and real solution. But if it is negative, then it takes a imaginary values. So like this only we have to discuss the cases. So case 1 is called as heavy damping, or you can say over damping. Write it as case 1 heavy damping, or you can say, many say over damping, where he says b square is greater than omega square. Is it clear? So when it happens, what you say that yg will be? And listen very carefully. This b square minus omega square is being a positive quantity, but less than b. Remember this thing. This is, in this condition, what will happen? Root b square will be a positive quantity, but it will be less than b. So what will happen to yg? Yg was c e minus b root over b square minus omega square t plus b e over minus b minus of minus b omega square times t. Now you yourself tell me what will happen, please. So what will happen? This is positive, but it is less than b, means this term is negative. It is written as something e power negative plus again d power negative. So what will happen? It is like something e power negative. Means exponentially decreasing curve we will get. So we get curve like this. Now this can never be zero because both are negative. So anything comes for zero? Any solution we are finding for zero? No. Because it is exponentially decreasing. That something constant into exponentially decreasing. So, like this. Okay, this is y, this is t. So this is the case of what? Over damping. See, these play a very vital role in the fabrication part. When we say research and development, okay? So in fabrication of any instrument, for example, deadbeat moving coil galvanometer works on this principle of over damping. Okay? That when the power supply is off, then it decreases, sudden decrease is there, but it never acquires zero. It will something point value it will take. Same way when you find ammeter and voltmeter, you have seen this ammeter and voltmeter. This is a case of critical damping. In critical damping, this curve tends to zero. We will see how. This will become zero. Means as soon as you switch off the supply, there will be a sudden decrement of the pointer towards the zero. So they plays a very vital role because the spring attached to that pointer is being fabricated to perform over damping, to perform critical damping, to perform the under damping. Is that clear to you? So next case we have to study is, critical damping. Yeah. Critical damping means b square equals to omega square, or you can write b square minus omega square is zero. Anything you can write. So what happens in this is, it's a very contradictory case. See, we are starting with that b square minus omega square is zero, so this is called as critical damping. But actually, practically, when we say this term cannot be equal to zero, this cannot be equal to zero practically. So see why it's a contradictory. I have started the topic name says b square minus omega square has to be zero. But practically it is not possible. So what we say is that, we say that b square minus omega square, or you can say the root, it's tending to zero. Or I name it as b dash, and this b dash is tending to zero. Are you getting the point? So don't get confused here. Okay. The thing here is, ideally we are saying b square minus omega square is zero, but practically it is not possible. And this is damping is a practical case. So we are taking this as b dash, and we are putting b dash is tends to 0. Now when it is tends to 0, so you know yg. So yg is c e power minus b plus root of b square minus omega square times t plus d e. Now till this point of time you got this general solution by heart. Okay. Now in spite of root b square minus omega square, you put b dash. and solve it and take some common terms you will find. So by work on it is CE power minus B plus, so multiplicative way, T plus B dash T plus D E times minus D T minus B dash T. Is it okay? Now E power minus B T will be constant, so I am taking E power minus B T here, so it will be C B dash T plus D E power minus B dash T, beta dash T. Now if you know the approximation that e power x is being approximated to 1 plus x where x is tend to 0. You know this approximation? You don't know. See, conceptual is also correct. E power 0 is 1. So e power 0, so this x is tending to 0. So e power 0 has to be 1. So 1 plus x, now x tending to 0, it will become 1 only. Are you getting what I am saying? Conceptually also it's correct. But approximation, if you know, if you have studied in maths also, the approximation is like this only. So e power x will tend to 1 plus x and e power minus x tends to 1 minus x. So let's apply this approximation here. So you will get a term like, so if I apply, you got by g as e power minus bt C 1 plus B dash T plus D times 1 minus of B dash T. So it's just mathematics, that's why I'm going a bit fast. So you will get E power like C plus D plus C minus D times B dash T. Now, here you can see that this term says it is exponentially decreasing. And if C becomes equals to D, then this terms will become 0. So means this terms tending make it into 0. Therefore, what curve we get it? We get it like this. Means this will go to 0. This is y versus t curve. So it is exponential decreasing due to e power minus bt. And this term is making to meet with 0 condition. Is that clear? Whereas in first case we didn't find any term, so that it can be 0. So this is the case of critical damping. Where we find this? Means at sudden you will find that pointers becomes to 0, like voltmeter, ammeter you will find. Voltmeter and many. That is under damping, and it is the most important case. Okay. Case 3, that is under damping, or here we say that d square minus omega square is a negative quantity, or I say is b square is greater than omega square. Okay, so these are the possible conditions for which under damping. Okay. Now, means to say that root over b square minus omega square becomes which quantity? Negative. That is imaginary quantity, or I can say. So, to make it more comfortable, what I do is, I take iota root of b square minus, iota if I take a, it will be omega square minus of b square. Is this and this is exactly the same thing I have written. You know what is iota? Iota is nothing but root over minus x. It's an imaginary number. Because this becomes now imaginary. So what I am writing it as, I am writing b square minus omega, means I am taking minus 1. Basically what I am doing is, this is what we have. So I am taking minus of omega square minus of b square. Will be the same thing. Both are same thing. So now minus, this is written minus 1 basically. So minus 1 is iota and root over omega square. What is my intention to take it is, this iota will be depicted when we get the result. So I got iota over root over b is omega square and b square. And I am taking this root quantity as beta. Because I have taken b dash in, that critical damping, so I'm taking it. So you got it iota beta. Put into the general solution. So you got C e power. If I write it minus b like t plus dt plus d times e power minus bt minus b beta t. The same things will go. Taking e power minus bt as common, you will find it as c e power bt plus d power minus bt. Now if you know the form e power, iota is here, iota bt minus iota t. Now you know that e power iota theta is what? Can I write it as cos theta plus iota sine of theta? If it is iota minus I theta, you have been studying in your complex numbers. Okay. So it is cos theta minus of iota sine theta. Is it okay? So same thing I am going to substitute now here. So this equation becomes e power minus b times t of c times cos of b t beta t plus iota sine of beta t. Is that okay? Plus d times of cos of beta t minus iota of sine of beta t. The expression becomes this. Now rearrange the terms, you will get what? E power minus bt c cos beta and d cos beta. If I take cos beta as common, you got is cos beta. You write it here as c plus d. Now c is iota sin beta minus d iota sin beta. So I can write it as c minus d iota of sin beta t. So this expression becomes this. Now if you see that it is cos beta and sin beta, so if I say this is nothing but sin phi and this is nothing but this c minus d iota is cos phi, so can you come with an expression that it is written as, or you can write a, a is amplitude, okay, no problem, e power beta a of sin phi cos beta t plus a of sin beta t cos of phi. Now is this terms give you a kick of sin a plus b? Does it? So the whole equation becomes like okay, if I remove this stuff, so the equation becomes e power minus bt it becomes e power minus b times t a of sine bt plus phi. Means that this is exponentially decreasing. E power minus bt concludes that it is exponentially decreasing. But this sine term decreases that this is exponentially decreasing with a sine wave. Means sine wave is decreasing. Are you getting it? E power minus bt conclude that it is decreasing. Minus bt means it is decreasing. How it is decreasing? With a sine function it is decreasing. So in case of underdamping, we get as the term decreases sinusoidally. So this is the important case or a practical case which we see in day to day life, that the it is decreasing with the sine function. Is that clear to you? Underdamping, it is an important point for underdamping. That first of all, what we have done is we have considered omega b square minus omega square as iota root of omega square minus b square. Then we have used the form, Eklund's form, to get in terms of cos and sine. Then we have reduced in terms of sine a sine b. Sine of a plus b, that is sine a cos b plus sine b cos a, and we got this term. Is that clear? Is this critical damping clear to you? Is that clear to you? Okay. Now we will move forward with forced vibrations. Now, forced vibration. When I say forced vibration, what is it? I told you that in this chapter, we are not going to deal with something new. It will be the same thing, but different, that aspects will be different. For example, if I recall the things, we have studied that in spring, simple spring mass system, we studied that F net, that F restoring is only there. So we write it directly proportional to K. So we write F net is minus K. Then MA will become d2y by dt square. Then we set up a differential equation here. Then we have studied, if you remember, damping. In damping, what we say is that there is an opposing force. So F restoring also comes into play. And F damping comes into play. So F net is equals to F restoring plus F damping. Similarly, here, if we get the meaning of force vibration, we will easily get the differential equation. Now, if you remember in damping, what is we have seen? In damping, we have seen that this is like a pendulum, and if I release it, after some time, it stops. It stops. So, if I have to make it continuous, means if I have to make it continuous, so what I have to do, I have to give some external force again and again. Again and again, I have to give some. Again and again, I have to give the force. Are you getting it? So, let me tell you from this lesson. Okay. Let it be. So like this is a cluster, okay. So when I'm giving the jerk, it will come to stop, it will stop after some time. For make it continuous, I have to give some continuous force after some time. Like when it comes here, I have to give. And it's like you have gone to a playground, and if you have seen that weight swing, in which you have to shift, like, okay, this kind of swing. Okay, you have to sit here. So a person who is there has to give external force. वो झूला देखा ना जो धक्का मार के हम झूलाते हैं ऊपर जाता है फिर नीचे आता है. It's like, हाँ. तो होता क्या उसमें? जो पीछे खड़ा होता है वो कब फोर्स देता है? जब आप पीछे आ रहे हो. Means it gives a periodic force. सबसे important part. वो ये नहीं कि हर बार आपको पकड़ के रखता है. वो तब देता जब आप पीछे की तरफ आते हो. Here also in pendulum also. जब ये pendulum यहाँ आएगा तभी ना फोर्स देंगे हम. Then only we will give the force. Means to say that it's a periodic. Means we are providing an external force to make the motion continuous. That is called as forced vibration. Means forcefully we are making it to vibrate. That is to maintain its amplitude. Is that clear? So what will happen here is, both the things will come. F restoring will come into play, F damping will come into play, and F external will come into play. So what will be F net if I say so? So F net will become F restoring or F damping plus F of external. Is that clear? So likewise we will get the differential equation. So your F restoring is directly proportional to Y. This I told you till dy by dt. And this external I say is F naught sine of omega d times t. Omega d times t. I am writing it as omega d. Omega d is not as omega. Omega d is called as driving frequency here. Driving frequency. Okay. So if I have to talk about, so F net becomes what? F restoring, F of damping, plus F of external. So what is F restoring? Can you tell me? Minus K times Y, minus R dy by dt, plus E naught, oh sorry, sorry, F naught sine of omega dt. Now why this is positive quantity whereas these are negative quantity? Because both are opposing the motion, whereas this is supporting the motion. The word says force vibration means forcefully we are making the vibration. Means it is doing in favor of the motion, whereas these are working in opposition of the motion. Are you getting this point? Why it is positive quantity? So F naught sine omega dt. Why I have taken sine? Because it's a priori. After some time you have to give the external force, not always. If it is always, then F naught directly. Okay. But force vibration says that after some time we have to provide it. So F naught becomes this. So you know next time what to do. Now bring these terms this side and you will get the differential equation. So F net will becomes MA and A will be d2y by dt square. So I am writing M d2y by dt square plus K times y plus R dy by dt is equals to F naught sine of omega d times. So let this be remain here only because this is a positive quantity. So the differential equation for force will be what? Now if you divide this equation with M, so this will be M and F naught by M. That is, if I divide it by M, so this will becomes M and here also you get M. So the equation becomes like d2y by dt square plus R by M I will write first. Dy by dt plus k times m y equals to f naught by m sine of omega d times t. Now what the next is that r by m will be replaced by 2b and k by m will be replaced by omega square, is it? So I do here only, so you have to do next derivation or next line you have to put it. Is it okay? Okay. Now we have to get the solution for this equation. Is it okay? Now what will be the solution for this equation? So we have to get damping oscillation we get y as a and e power alpha t. In simple we write a sin omega dt. So why we write we take a help of what? We take a help of mathematics and we write that y is equals to a omega dt minus phi. A sin omega dt minus phi. So next you know already that what is dy by dt? Tell me. Is it A omega d cos of omega d t minus phi? Or I can say it says d 2y by dt square again differentiated. We will get A omega square d sin of omega d t minus of phi. Are you getting this point? Now you again have to put this equation where? Back to this equation. So y, then d2y will be a omega square d sine of omega d t minus phi plus 2 times b of a, this term here, omega d cos of omega dt minus phi plus omega square y. What is y? A sine of omega dt minus phi is equals to, now I am writing this f naught by fm as f naught. Okay, just for the simplification. So I will write F naught here, and I am also writing omega dt as minus phi plus phi. What I am doing is, let me tell you, this was omega dt now, so I am subtracting or adding the phi. Will it make any change? It will not make a change, but this will becomes F naught will be here sine of omega dt minus sine omega dt minus phi cos of phi plus cos of omega dt minus phi plus sine of phi. That is, this is A, this is B, that is sine of A plus B. So now rearrange the terms here. How you will rearrange? I am getting omega square d and omega square here. Sorry, minus, yeah. Minus, okay. So, like, yeah. So, omega square d, if I take omega square d minus omega square, you will get A sine of omega d t minus phi plus 2 times B A omega d cos of omega d t minus phi. Now you compare this equation and this equation. You have to compare this equation and this equation. So I'm comparing, I think you got as like F naught cos omega dt minus F naught cos phi as omega square d minus omega square. And I think you got F naught sine phi as, so this is cos omega dt, 2b a omega d, 2b a omega d. Is that clear to you? See, it's a mathematics, purely mathematics. I tell you once again, what I did is, we got this differential equation, and we have did y equals to a sin omega dt minus phi is the solution of this equation. So we got the solution of this equation, then we differentiated again, and then again to get d2y by dt square. Then we put the values again back to it, and we have solved this, we have beautified the equation, and we have put omega dt. In spite of that, I have added the phase and subtracted the phase, so it will make no difference. So I have got the terms. On comparing, I get this. So finally, what we have to get is, our purpose is to get the phi and amplitude. So I think I got two equations from it. F naught cos of phi is equals to omega square d minus omega square a, and F naught of sine phi as 2b a of omega d. Now first thing is to get phi. So how I will get phi? Divide 1 by 2. So I will get 10 phi as equals to, how I am getting 1 divided by 2? You will get 2b omega d upon omega square d minus omega square. So you got phi here as tan inverse 2b omega d upon omega d square minus omega square. This is the first result we get in force vibration. Then we have to get amplitude. How we will get amplitude? So for getting amplitude, my mind says 1 square plus 2 square. Square and add. So when you square and add, this becomes F naught square is equals to, this becomes omega square d minus omega square times a square plus 4b square omega square d times a square. So a square is equals to F naught square upon omega d square minus omega square whole square plus 4 v square omega square d. Is it okay? So for root, oh sorry, this is a. Now root, so root will be this. Check it out. So you got amplitude as f naught over omega root of omega square d minus omega square square plus 4 d square omega square d, whereas f naught is f naught by m. F naught is f naught by m. This you know, na? We have substituted this. Is it okay? So this is what we say is a forced vibration. Again, like damping oscillation, we have studied the case. Here also we will see the cases. Is it okay with you people? Check it once. How we have got this? Let's start with case. Forced vibrations. So first case we say is that when driving frequency is low. Driving frequency is low, that is omega square d is less than omega square. Okay. Now both the terms are there in front of you. You only tell me what will happen. Like for 5, what will happen? This omega d is small. So means it is written as tan inverse of 0 only. I am not taking this term. I am taking this. This is 0 now. This is tending to 0. Because omega d is very small. Means 5 becomes tan inverse of 0, that is 0. Is that clear? Now amplitude. For amplitude, if you see it, what you will find it, omega d is very small. Means this is 0 and this is 0. Means you are left with f naught of root over omega's power 4. Is that so? Means you got it as f naught power omega square. F naught power omega square. It is a case of when driving frequency is low. Now, see, why it is important, why phi and a amplitude is important. Because in question, it will not give you whether it is a case of low driving frequency, high driving frequency. They will give a driving frequency data and they will give natural frequency data. So you need to find out what is that. That is omega d is greater than omega or omega is greater than omega d. Then according to that only you have to go further. Okay. Now second case, when driving frequency is high. When driving frequency is high, what will happen? Is high. That is omega d is greater than omega square. So let me check what happens to phi. Now phi, omega d is much greater than it. So omega, this will become 0. 0. Now omega square will be 1 omega will cancel out. 1 upon, that is omega d is very high. So it's very high. So 2b omega d will be this. So minus of it. Minus of 0. So tan inverse minus of 0 will be what? Will be minus of something something. Will be what? Nothing but pi. Will be nothing but pi. Therefore, amplitude if I check now, omega has to be neglected. So omega square d is very high. So when this is very high, so this is neglected, okay, in terms of this, because this becomes very high. This square becomes very high, so this is neglected. So I write it as f naught over omega square of d. Is it okay? Is it okay? And the third case, that is an important case, when driving frequency is low, when it is equal. Driving frequency equal to natural, that is omega d is equals to omega. So what will phi becomes? Phi will be 1 upon 0, that is pi by 2 tan inverse 1 of something upon 0. So it will be pi by 2, that is 1 upon infinite. And amplitude becomes what? F naught over, this terms will become 0, 2b omega d. Okay. 2d omega times d. So these are very important. Now this case is very important, that is third case, when driving frequency is equals to natural frequency. Do you know what is resonance? Resonance is the principle when external frequency matches with natural, and when this happens is we get the what maximum amplitude. If you have remembered in sounds you have might studied, okay. So resonance is the principle when the external frequency meets with natural frequency, and when this happens the amplitude becomes maximum. Here also what we are seeing is this angular frequency that is driving matches with the natural, means this is a case of resonance. Means this is a case of what? It is a case of resonance, means this amplitude is the maximum amplitude. So whenever you find a term called as maximum amplitude, you should come across this case. Means to say that if you draw the curve, what will happen it? Okay. Like we say that, okay, this is no damping, this we says less damping, and this we says higher damping, okay, or you can say that driving omega d is equals to omega, and from here also you can write that omega d is less than omega and omega d is less than omega. Okay, so this is called as resonance curve. Okay, this is called as resonance curve. Means this is a case of what? Resonance. Means resonance means maximum amplitude. Maximum amplitude. So this is forced vibration. Now this is what all about, force vibration.